Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you don't know, or if this is your first time meeting me, welcome. My name is Jessica Alexandria. I'm the creator of Bahati Life Apothecary, and I'm a professional astrologer. In today's video, we're gonna be talking about your moon sign, why it's important, why it's significant, and why you would wanna take extra time to understand this so that you can better understand yourself. This is one of those videos that has been highly requested, at least on my YouTube platform and in my Instagram, or on my Instagram. If you don't know this about me, I'm all about understanding your personal power, understanding the planets, understanding how their energy impacts us here on Earth. And I'm all about making sure that you feel strong and supported so that you can make the most impactful change while you're here on Earth. Of course, we have our sun sign that helps us to better understand ourselves and our personal identities, but it's our moon sign that helps to give us strength, that helps us to understand what it is that we emotionally need, again, so that we can make the largest impact here on Earth, and that while we're making that large, lasting impact in our legacy, that we don't feel depleted in the process or at the very end of your journey. So for the sake of this video, I'm gonna call this energy that it is I'm talking about, I'm gonna call it moon sign magic. So let's go ahead and dive right into the nitty gritty. So what exactly is your moon sign? Your moon sign is the position of the moon the moment that you entered the earth. In other words, this is where the moon was transiting at the time of your birth, the exact placement of the moon at the moment of your birth. This is something that doesn't change and is pretty much pretty unique to you. What makes this so unique to you is not just the placement of the moon, meaning the sign that it is that it's sitting at the time that it was that you're born, but it's also the moon's relation and connection to other planets and other angles within your personal chart. Me personally, I would love to dive into your specific chart, but for the sake of this video, which is going to be seen by a large number of people, I have to keep it kind of general and try to make it as specific as possible to serve a larger population in a small amount of time. For that reason, again, I'm gonna focus on moon sign magic, which is what I'm gonna call it, and I think is what is probably gonna be the title of this video. Why this is so magical is that this gives a compass, a tool that the universe gives to us, or that the divine gives to us, to better understand ourselves, or for you to better understand yourself. Your moon represents your emotional feelings, your emotional needs, how you process your feelings, what makes you feel safe, and what makes you feel supported. On top of that, your moon sign is also your ability to magnetize and to radiate certain energy out into the world to help you to attract or to make others feel more comfortable with you. That's something that a lot of people aren't talking about on the internet, but we're gonna talk about today. First thing I want you to know about your moon sign, or in this case, how to work your moon sign magic, is that the moon sign, your placement of your moon within your natal chart, your astrological chart, shows you your emotional needs. This is your compass, your tool that the divine gives you to better understand what it is that you need in order to fill your emotional needs, again, to make you feel safe and supported. When it comes to your moon sign, or for the sake of the video, how to work your moon sign magic, the first thing I want to do is look at what sign your moon is falling in your astrology chart or your natal chart. This helps me as your astrologer, or you looking into your chart or another person's chart, it helps you and I to better understand your deeper, more subconscious needs and desires. For example, let's say your sun sign falls in the sign of Aries. So your ego, your identity, your self, sense of self comes from this energy that you exude that is a part of your being to go out, to achieve, to accomplish, to be assertive, to be dominant, to be a leader. But your moon sign falls in the sign of Cancer. Even though, yes, you want to be a pioneer, you want to be a leader, that Cancer energy, when it's done going out in the world, when it's done dominating and being a leader for everyone, that Cancer side of you wants to withdraw. Cancers are known for their own leadership qualities as well, but they don't like to highlight and project their feelings out into the world or share their feelings out to the rest of the world, although they're fueled by their feelings. So at the end of the day, after running a business or running a marathon or taking on some major goal, at the end of the day, there's this emotional need to withdraw from the rest of the world, to nurture yourself, to closet yourself up, and maybe even release, emotionally release in some way, shape, or form. If you stay in this space of dominating, putting yourself out there, achieving your goals, and you ignore your emotional needs, the emotional needs of Cancer, you don't understand that your moon sign and your emotional needs are in alignment with the energy of Cancer, then you can feel really depleted. You can feel very exhausted. When you understand the sign that your moon falls in and you understand how to work your moon sign magic, you will understand in and out, again, your subconscious needs, your subconscious desires, and the fastest ways and the most efficient ways to replenish and to fill your own cup so that the next day or whenever you can go back in and accomplish your goals or do whatever it is that you're called to do here on Earth that's connected to your purpose and that's in alignment with your highest and greatest good for all of us here on Earth. Second thing that I want you to understand about your moon sign, or in this case, how to work your moon sign magic, is to understand your own sensitivities. We all have them. There are things in this world that make us feel very vulnerable, that make us feel really raw, that make us feel very open. And depending on your moon sign, it will show how open you are to sharing that with other people, or how closed off you are to sharing that with other people, or even exploring those aspects within yourself. Now, as a professional astrologer, and something that I'll share with you if you're in beginner to intermediate astrology, is that professional astrologers will look at the placement and the condition of your moon. Is it squaring off with any other planet? Is it flowing with another planet? Does it feel supported? Does it feel isolated? What is the overarching energy of the condition of your moon? I believe, as a spiritual being, as a spiritual teacher, as an astrologer, as an intuitive, I've seen, and it's been proven to me, that there's no such thing as right or wrong. It just is what it is. And the same thing is true for your natal chart. If you have squares in your chart, or if you have flows in your chart, you have some that are challenges or some that are flows. It's not that it's a good thing or a bad thing. It just is what it is. It's a tool, a resource that the divine gives you, again, to better understand yourself so you can find out what works for you so that you can use that to your advantage. If you understand that your moon sign is squaring off with Saturn, which creates this feeling of isolation and a loneliness or depression or this vibe of melancholy. I don't know if I'm saying that word correctly. As a Virgo, I still butcher my words. If you understand that that's falling within your chart, you understand that that's something that you may have to live with, or that you will have to live with for the rest of your life. That's not to take away your power. It's to help you to better understand what will make you feel powerful. If you know that you're susceptible to sadness, to feeling lost or isolated or depressed, then you can factor in even more time to nurture and to nourish yourself to help you to feel stronger despite the fact that there's that challenge within, or that resistance or blockage within your life that's embedded within your being. Now, like I said in the very beginning of this video, your moon sign is very unique to you in a lot of ways, because we have to factor it into all of your natal chart and what makes you you. We cannot change it. It is what it is. But again, when you know what you're working with, then you can make it work for you and not against you. One thing that I tell my clients, even challenges, and a lot of times challenges are opportunities for growth. It's your legacy of what it is that you are going to give back to the world and how you can learn to give to yourself. That's the same thing that we see when we see squares or opposition within the natal chart when it comes to your moon sign or any of the other planets within your zodiac chart, within your natal chart. It's learning how to better understand what presents a difficulty for you so that, again, you can nurture it, so that you can fill it and not fall victim to it or feel powerless within that. I will say that if you do have challenges or opposition and squares within your chart, again, it's something that you can use to build upon. However, when you understand and you're working with your moon sign magic, you will find and deeply understand, profoundly understand your under the current, under the radar subconscious desires, again, so that you can feel supported while you're here on Earth. If your moon sign has more ease, like the trines and the sextiles that are found within the astrology chart, then it's easy for you in a lot of ways to share, to connect with others, and to feel supported. You can still build with that energy in order to feel supported, in order to help yourself to thrive. But also remember that sometimes without that challenge, without that opposition, you might not feel a desire or a push or a pressure to heal certain aspects within yourself that are embedded within your natal chart. So again, there is no such thing as a positive or a negative. It just is what it is. When you understand your chart, when you understand what you're working with, when you understand the planets and the energy that they bring, you can make it work for you and not against you. The third thing that I want to talk to you when it comes to your moon sign and working with your moon sign magic is the placement of the moon, the sign that it falls into, and how it's relating to other planets and other angles within your chart will show me how you process your feelings. This is something, again, that it's not so unique because there's others that may process their feelings in the same way that you do, but it's unique enough that it's another tool within your box of self-discovery and self-understanding to help you to understand that this is what I need, or this is the time that it is that I need in order to digest, to process all of what's happening around me at this moment in time. There's some signs that are way faster or way more reactive when it comes to processing their feelings. There's others that go really, really deep with their feelings. There's some that like to keep it surface level and they're fine with that. And there's others who take time, legit time to process, and it's not a very fast process. It's more of, okay, step by step, don't rush me. The more that you rush me, the more that I'm gonna fight this. I'm looking at you, earth signs. This is one of my favorite tools to use when building relationships, is understanding not only my moon sign and working my moon sign magic for myself, but looking at another person's moon sign and seeing how they can work and use their moon sign magic to connect with others so that we can connect and build together easy and effortless. Now, I want to move on to something that I feel as though a lot of people aren't talking about on the internet, but you guys know, or if you don't know, now you know, I'm very thorough and detailed and specific when it comes to the messages and the information and the education that it is that I'll share here on Bahati Life YouTube. Now, this magical trick that I want to share with you if you are interested in working your moon sign magic is understanding your magnetism. Now, don't misinterpret this or misunderstand me when I talk about magnetism. What I've noticed is that in the realms of astrology, sometimes we try to put things into certain boxes. And I can understand that because there are a lot of rules when it comes to astrology, but realize that in the spiritual world, there is only energy that is that we're working with. The planets exude certain energy. They have their own personalities. They have their own preferences and things that is that they love and the things that is that they hate and the things that is that they can do or the things that they can accomplish and things that they just have no interest in even addressing. I understand that in the world of astrology, we think about attraction and magnetism and connect that to the planet Venus. And that is true. Venus is all about what we are attracted to and how we attract others, but the moon sign is what keeps a person enticed. It's what makes a person feel nurtured. It's what you can use to help a person feel comfortable with you and nurtured and supported by you. It's the gifts that you can use if you understand your moon sign and you know how to work with your moon sign magic, how to make another person feel comfortable, supported, nurtured, nourished. And those are the gifts that is that you can bring not only to yourself but to others as well. It's what makes you unique. It's what makes you stand out. It's how you comfort others, and again, how they feel comfortable in your presence, in your energy field, working with you, building relationships with you. At the same time, like I said, it's not all good or bad. Yes, there's those aspects of yourself when you know how to work your moon sign magic when it comes to this is what I can do, or this is how I make others feel, and this is what it is that I need. You can take those needs and share them with other people. You can apply it to other people. Just like there's things that you can do in order to replenish yourself, there's things that you can do to repulse and to push people away. For example, let's say you have your moon sign falling in the sign of Virgo. Virgo is known for being very hypercritical. It's known for being very perfectionistic. It's known for needing to take its time to process, to digest the things that is that it's feeling and put it in a space in a way that is practical, that makes sense, that's reasonable, and that's grounded. So those are the quote unquote positive aspects when it comes to understanding that moon sign magic and how to work that moon sign magic. But on the flip side, if you understand that your moon is falling in the sign of Virgo, then there are certain traits that can, again, repulse and push people away. For example, if you have this emotional need to kind of critique and to compartmentalize things to help you to have a better sense of control and structure within your life that makes you feel safe and supported, you could overly criticize and overly push people away that repulses them, that makes them want to run away from you. If you know how to work with the energy of the planets, when you know the energy of what it is that you're working with, not only in what's going on in the external world, but what's going on in your internal world and how you're making others feel just by you honoring your feelings and your own needs and your own desires, you can understand the impact that you have on others. So how does this make you powerful? How is this moon sign magic? This is understanding the difference that is that you make. And a word that is that I like to use, because I'm all about magic and intention and manifestation, is the word manipulation. Now, in society, in a lot of societies, a lot of people have a hard time with the word manipulation because they're like, we think of it as a bad thing. But in reality, what manipulation means is that the things that is that you're doing match your intention of what it is that you're trying to create. That doesn't have to be a good or a bad thing. It just is what it is. If your intention is for good, if your intention is for positive, for example, if you're trying to connect with someone and build a relationship with someone, then you are going to do everything in your power in order to help that person feel comfortable and secure so that you guys can draw in and build a relationship together. That's quote unquote manipulation, meaning that your will and your intention is to build a bond with your best friend or whoever. So you are going to put out vibes and do things to help that relationship to manifest in a way that feels good for the both of you. On the flip side, there's some of you guys who will take that and manipulate others, meaning like, I don't want my boyfriend or my girlfriend going out, so I'm gonna do certain things or say certain things to control them. That's the very evil side of manipulation. It's all about your intention. So when it comes to working your moon sign magic, you are understanding how you make others feel so that you can quote unquote manipulate the circumstances around you in order to match your will, in order to match your intention and keep your intention in a high space, a space of high vibrations. Please don't misunderstand me when I say the word manipulate. I'm just using that word because I don't have a better word to work with, but it's pretty much, again, what it is that you are trying to achieve, what it is that you're trying to accomplish, and understanding that there's two sides to every sword and knowing the strength of that sword and how to work with that sword in order to work your magic, set intention, and to build long-lasting relationships, lasting bonds, better business, material goods, whatever it is, fill in the blank. All right, you guys, I hope that that makes sense. I know that it's kind of a lot to process. Let me know down in the comments if you have any questions, if I need to clear up anything. I'm more than happy to do that for you. I'm really open to taking requests for videos in the future, especially when it comes to authentic knowledge, when it comes to education, when it comes to information sharing. I'm a Virgo. I'm a Virgo moon, so it's my desire to be of service to you guys and to give you guys the best high quality perfection as much as I can give to you guys in a way that allows you to understand it inside and out. So let me know down in the comments what it is that you would like to hear, what it is that you'd like to see. I'm going to read all of them. I'll be more than happy to serve that to you. In the meantime, make sure that you are subscribed to my YouTube channel because there's plenty more videos where this came from, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!